had said, I will continue with the discussion. Now see, what is happening? See, if I don't have prism, so ray should follow along the OPM path. But since there is prism, ray is following QR path. So this angle, I'm zooming it. This angle is my fast angle of deviation for the incident ray. So name is at delta suffix 1. Clear? Whereas this angle is my second angle of deviation, which is known as delta 2. The diagram, let's see. You can see or not, or the diagram I will share with you in the description box. That will help you a lot. Now let's go for the discussion. Now see. If I see carefully what is happening, we know for a triangle, if I am continuing with a triangle, that exterior angle is the sum of two interior angles. This geometrical theorem we know that for a triangle, the exterior angle is the sum of two interior angles. Now, suppose I am considering the triangle PMQ. So, from triangle PMQ. Okay. So, who is the exterior angle? Angle LMQ. Angle LMQ is my exterior angle. So, angle LMQ is equal to the sum of two interior angles. Who are the opposite interior angle for this triangle? This delta 1 and delta 2 are the interior angle, or rather I can say PMQ, MQP are the interior angles. So write down, that is equal to PMQ plus triangle MQP. So these two angles, that one of that means what I am telling, that angle LMQ is the exterior angle, whereas angle PMQ and MQP, these are the interior angle. Done. Now resuming it. Okay. So if I am having that, so LMQ, what I have denoted as delta. So delta equal to PMQ is my delta 1 and MQP is delta 2. Give it equation number 1. Done. This is my first thing. Done. Now coming for next half of the section. Now see, from this triangle, what rest of the things I know? I know that this one, this OP, we are having incident angle I1. Now I know if we are having that just no refraction. So no refraction means here, no R1 means this angle, this delta 1 plus R1 should equal to I1. Yes or no? Why? I am telling you, again drawing here, this is my structure actually. So this is my incident ray OP and this is PQ. Now I have drawn here one normal. So what is that? This is my I1. Now according to that, this is my delta 1. Now if there is no angle of refraction, so this I1 should equal to this I1. Am I clear? Because they are the vertically opposite angle. So here this I1 should equal to NPM. Clear? So write down. From figure, what I can write, that angle of incidence I1 is equal to angle NPM because of vertically opposite angle. Vertically opposite angle, I think no confusion. So they are the vertically opposite angle. Now let's see what is the meaning of angle NPM. If I am going for angle NPM, clearly for diagram we can write that angle NPM is equal to delta 1 plus R1. So therefore, I1 equal to delta 1 plus R1. any confusion, we can write that. So give it equation number 2. The same thing happening here also. See, here in the next case, I am enlarging it. Just wait. In the next case, what is happening? This is my emergent ray, and this emergent ray is vertically opposite angle of NQM. Okay, so from figure, angle I2 should equal to angle NQM. Angle NQM, I think you can see or not. Yes, angle NQM. Now, if you see carefully, angle NQM is basically what? Angle NQM is basically my delta 2 plus R2. So, I2 equal to delta 2 plus R2. That is equation 3. Done. So, after that done, in description box, notes given, there everything given. Here just understood the fact. Now, coming to that next. Here, I am just writing the equation. Otherwise, I will forget that delta equal to delta 1 plus delta 2 equal to equation 1. Now, coming for next one. Now, see. If you see carefully, here two things happening. What is that? If I am considering this part, means A, P, N, L, sorry, N, Q, A. This is a quadrilateral. Yes or no? So, A, P, N, Q is a quadrilateral. No confusion. So, A, P, L, Q is a quadrilateral. Done? So, what does the meaning of quadrilateral? That sum of all angle is equal to 60 degree. So, write down from quadrilateral A, P, N, Q that sum of the all angle means angle A, this one, plus angle A, P, N, plus angle P, N, Q, sorry, P, N, Q, plus angle N, Q, A, all make 360 degree, clear. Now see, who are what? Now angle A, P, N, what is angle A, P, N? See, this is the obviously I1, this is I1, already I know this angle is actually I1. So, remaining thing is what? Since it is a normal, so this angle is I1, so angle A, P, N. If I am going for only angle A, P, N, so in place of angle A, P, N, I can write 90 degree. Why? Because this one is 90 degree, sorry, this one is 90 degree, this one are normal. So, normal means which always makes an angle 90 degree. So, angle APN is also equal to angle AQN. Both are 90 degree to one another because of only one thing. If you had drawn normal, so this one is what? 90 degree. Clear? This one is what? 90 degree. So, remaining two half means this half and this half, these are also 90 degree. So, in place of angle APN, I can put angle A plus 90 degree. Similarly, angle NQA. NQA. This is also 90 degree because since it is a normal, so this is 90 degree. This is 90 degree. Another two half also 90 degree. So another 90 degree. Okay. So 90 degree plus angle P. N, Q. Leave it like that. So, this is equal to 360 degree. Done. Now, 290 degree makes the things as 180 degree. In next video, I am continuing this.